As we look back over these difficult years, we just recognized the anniversary, the 35th anniversary of the attack on the French paratrooper barracks and the French and the U.S. Marine peacekeeper barracks there in Beirut 35 years ago last week. And you look at what has happened since that time, you recognize that in most cases, the breeding ground for this is not something that can be addressed by the military. Our general view is that State Department has the lead with AID, and we lead with ideas, we lead with the example of our own country, and we work with like-minded nations in this regard. My personal view, when I, during the 3 years I was out of the Marines and I was on a university campus, had time to think about what had happened, I believed that the U.S. foreign policy had become militarized, and so I come back into this job, and my view was that we had to have State Department in the lead, and the military had to be an enabling, supporting element to this, because you simply couldn't shoot your way out of this problem. At one point, I was frustrated enough with some aspects of State Department's budget that in my testimony, I said, if you don't fully fund up on Capitol Hill, my testimony, if you don't fully fund the State Department, please buy more ammunition for me because I'm going to need it. As a rather blunt way of saying why we needed to keep America's foreign policy and our diplomats foremost in this effort.